This is one of the most common questions that I see on the internet about student engineering. Does GPA actually matter? How much do companies look at it? Is it important? Do I put it on my resume? So let's jump right into that in this video right now. Hey, 1% Nation, I'm Jake Voorhees, and you are watching episode 37 of the 1% Engineer Show, where we empower young engineers to rise to the top 1% of their career. So again, this question comes up so much on Reddit, Quora, other types of engineering and college blogs. Does GPA actually matter? Do I need to get a 4.0? Do I need to get a 3.5? Should I put it on my resume? And the answer is yes and no, but really, the core answer is no. So first let's talk general theory, and then we can look at some studies, then we can look at some media on this matter. But the reality is that a 4.0 is actually a scary thing for a job employer. A lot of negative connections are made when you have such a strong GPA. For example, the employer may think that you are less social and you were just a bookworm. So it actually makes you look bad to have a 4.0. So the strong area of GPAs to aim for is 3.0 and higher. Now, if you want to go to graduate school, if you want to go to medical school, law school after university, then you certainly need to get a higher GPA, because that's a good way to weed people out. So consider that if you know that master's degree or MBA or law is in your future, some engineering students take law after undergrad, then you definitely should be getting a 3.5 or higher. It is so competitive to get into grad programs that that's just an easy way to X people out. What engineering employers, what engineering companies are actually looking for is somebody who is ambitious outside of the classroom, someone who is standing out by being a member of clubs, by being a leader in an engineering society like ASCE or Robotics Society or some mechanical engineering society, and someone who is volunteering and someone who is maybe participating in some hobby at an advanced level, like intramural club team or something like this. But what people really want is well-balanced individuals, well-balanced humans to become a part of their team, people who are gonna get along with other people, who are gonna be able to communicate, who are not gonna be absolute antisocial bookworms and just stay in their dorm over the weekends and study and get that 4.0. Let's look at some studies on this topic and see what the experts have to say. Donald Hoyt from the University of Nebraska did a study connecting GPA to adult performance in the workplace, and we're going to take a look at what those engineering studies resulted in. Five of them were specifically for engineering students, and four out of the five found it inconclusive that GPA has an indication on your salary. And the last one of those five used some inconclusive assumptions, so they pretty much threw that one out. So there's not as much connection to the GPA you received and how much money you're going to make in the professional world. Google doesn't even ask for GPA for their applicants. They fully admit that it is an absolute poor indication of a quality engineer, of a quality person to join the Google team. They also say that the way you test for exams is total garbage, so we'll throw some quotes up about that. I also want to point out a Forbes article that was released and specifically talks about how they would rather have someone with a 3.2 who was working full-time on the side or was treasurer of some student organization compared to somebody who, say, has a 3.9 with no experience and no extracurriculars. So if you go on Reddit, you go on Quora, you look at engineering forums, you look at student forums, you will see the vast majority of people contributing to this conversation on the internet agree they do not think that GPA is a pure indicator of success in job placement, for success in your career road, success in the workplace. So keep that in mind, guys. You really want to have a balanced university future. If you were a crazy bookworm and striving for 4.0 last year, or you believe that that has to be the case for you this year or in all of your years to come as an engineering student, it's totally false. You want balance. You want to be involved in a bunch of stuff on the side. You want to make sure that you're always honing your communication, your networking, your professional development skills, not just getting good grades and study, hitting the books. So go out there and join that team, join that society, network, go to events, go to as many job fairs as possible, meet people. It's all about who you know anyways. I have only ever gotten job opportunities and offers based on existing relationships with engineers that I knew about. It wasn't about grades. It wasn't even about what I knew or what I had done before that application. It was somebody that I knew, somebody who I had a connection with because of a position I held previously. So definitely keep this stuff in mind, guys, for all of your future classes. Let 1% Nation know what you think about GPA and engineering in the comments below. Thanks for watching this video, guys. If you enjoyed it, consider subscribing because I release videos on Wednesdays and Saturdays, and lately a little bit more often, for engineering career success, engineering student success, so you can rise to the top 1% of your engineering field. Thanks for watching the 1% Engineer Show, guys, and stay hungry on your quest to become a 1% engineer. Cheers.